Clinical Presentation of Stroke by Dr. Mia Bernson-Leung.
The presentation of acute ischemic stroke in children can be similar to that of adults. The hallmark is the acute onset of a focal neurologic deficit. About 85% of children with arterial ischemic stroke will have focal signs, including hemiparesis in 60 to 80%, a speech difficulty in 10 to 35%, or visual field defects in 5 to 20%. Focal symptoms of ischemic stroke may be localizable to specific areas of brain tissue that correspond to the vascular territory of the occluded vessel. I'll highlight a number of these vascular syndromes, but it's important to recognize that children may not manifest all of the symptoms of a given vascular syndrome, and that other combinations of symptoms may be possible depending on the territory affected. Strokes affecting the anterior cerebral artery often involve weakness of the contralateral leg and may also have behavior changes. Strokes of the middle cerebral artery can manifest as weakness of the contralateral face and arm, a speech disturbance such as aphasia or dysarthria, a visual field deficit or hemianopia, inattention to stimuli on one half of the body or in one half of space called hemineglect, and sensory deficits. Stroke in the posterior cerebral artery territory can also produce visual field deficits and sensory deficits. Strokes in the vertebrobasilar system can be harder to identify because they often don't manifest with lateralized signs. For instance, symptoms of vertebrobasilar stroke can include dizziness, ataxia, impaired balance, abnormalities of eye movements or pupils, changes in speech or swallowing, and weakness and sensory changes in various patterns, as well as a decrease in the level of consciousness. Finally, occlusions of the cerebral veins and sinuses, such as CSVT, can produce decreased level of consciousness, headache, vomiting, and papilledema, particularly as a late sign. Children with ischemic strokes can also present with diffuse signs, making recognition that a stroke has occurred challenging. About 61 to 64% of children with arterial ischemic strokes will have diffuse signs, such as altered mental status in 42 to 52%, or headache in 24 to 40%. And in fact, about 10% of children with stroke may have only diffuse signs. Similarly, about 33 to 49% of children with an arterial stroke will have both focal signs and diffuse signs that are not referable to a specific vascular territory. There's an important relationship between stroke and seizures for children. About 25 to 31% of children with an arterial ischemic stroke will have a seizure around the time of presentation, and as many as 42% of younger children will have a seizure. This is in comparison to only 5% of adults having a seizure at the time of their stroke. Oftentimes, the acute onset of focal deficits is attributed to a post-ictal or Todd's paralysis, but it's important to recognize that the incidence of a new onset focal epilepsy presenting with a Todd's paralysis is about comparable to that of a new stroke. And so it's important to consider stroke for all first-time focal seizures, regardless of the presence of paralysis. About 37% of hemorrhagic strokes will have acute seizures, and 20 to 48% of CSVT will have acute seizures.